Assalamu alaikum. Hello guys, welcome to my channel. Thank you for clicking. If today is your first time here, you're welcome. And to my returning, thank you guys so much for always coming back. Thanks for the love and support. I really appreciate you guys. And Ramadan Kareem to you all. May Allah accept all our prayer, forgive us our sins, and grant us all our heart desires. So if this today is your first time here, you're highly welcome. And by name, Rizikat. Here in this channel, I talk about my life journey as a maid in Saudi Arabia. Please do me a favor by subscribing and don't forget to turn on the notification bell so that whenever I upload a video, you'll be notified. So guys, let's get into today's video about Ramadan in the Middle East. Yes guys, we all know, this Ramadan is the ninth month of in Islamic calendar, and during this month, every Muslim around the world fast. A week is not something really new to every one of us, but coming to Saudi Arabia, it's more celebrated in Saudi Arabia, compared to other countries. Yes, even me coming here, I'm a Muslim, but it's not being celebrated in a big way back in Nigeria, here in Saudi Arabia. Yes. It's not really easy during Ramadan here. Ramadan is festive period for them here in Saudi Arabia, of which they celebrate, and many family members, maybe that it has been long, they see each other, they came together to celebrate each other. That is just it's here, they celebrate Ramadan here, I don't even know, it's every day, fasting every day is like a party to them, they celebrate it in a bigger way, of which it's not been like that to me before now. Coming here, it's like I'm now seeing it new, even though I know fasting is not new, it's what I've been observing for long. I knew about, but the way they celebrate it here in Saudi Arabia is quite different. And this and during this Ramadan, I get to notice that many housemates here in Saudi Arabia, even me at times, I'll be kind of, oh God, so soon, you just be because of the stress, during this Ramadan, it's a very hectic period, it's a hectic period for every housemate, of which is not really easy. Even me, there is a video I do and I talk about the nature of my work. It shouldn't have been so much, which is my work is not that much, but during this Ramadan, it's more hectic, I have to be get involved in some work, of which is not really easy for me. It's so hectic to me. It's not really easy. Yes, because during this Ramadan, you get to see that maybe the way they prepare for Ramadan, and once the time is in, you get busy every day. We all know, even in a normal day, working is not really easy. The work is is very difficult and it's so much. But during this Ramadan, it will be something like times 10 of it. You'll be doing everything, especially people in the kitchen. It's not really easy. And yeah, when it came in terms of their meal, maybe their the iftar meal, it's varieties of meal they'll be cooking every day, every blessed day. And this their meal is just mainly pastries, of which is not really easy. Different varieties of pastries they will be doing, of which is not really, really easy. But to me, I think it's an opportunity for me. I know in other way, at times I will feel stressed, and also I'm glad for the month. It's an opportunity for me. This month is an opportunity for many of us, to get more closer to God, especially in terms of prayers. From the work is during daytime. Maybe in the morning like this, maybe towards before 4 p.m., you have more time for yourself. It also create time for us maybe to have more time for yourself. And again, get closer to God, maybe especially at night, because in a normal day, once I'm done for the day, I'll just go and sleep. But now there is more opportunity to pray at night for many of us. Of which, to me, I see it as an opportunity. it's not that hectic, but to many people, like again, I know why many people also find it difficult is that you have less sleep this time around. The work is much and you now have less sleeping because you don't have much time. If in some houses, it's not all every house is again, let me say it like that, because in some houses they won't sleep. It's like even my, let me say my, in my own house here now, not sleeping. Once you wake up like this at midday, maybe any movement from 5 p.m., you wake up till the next morning before you sleep, maybe after prayer, that is maybe after maybe around 4:30 to 5 a.m. in the morning before you sleep, then wake up at 12 p.m. again. But in some houses, it's not so. Once you are done, you sleep. But here in this, my house, and it's not only this house, many houses are, maybe let me say 70% of their houses are like that. They hardly sleep during Ramadan. And again, what I like about this Ramadan is that if you have high bosses that they like to shout in every little things, during this time, like they will just lower their self. They don't shout like that. All the time they will talk to you, have you do this, they mainly stay in their room this time, maybe reciting the Quran or once they are tired, they'll just lie down in their bed and be sleeping all day long. Like I also like that. That's one thing I love about this Ramadan again. But many people find it difficult. But to me, I think I find it so cool. Yes. And again, during this month of Ramadan, if you have people, maybe all those Arab people, maybe some of them find it hard to give out. Yes. But during this month of Ramadan, many of them, they give out. Maybe you may expect present from them, be it gift or money. Yes, during this time, like they do charities. I don't know for them, like in a normal day, many of them, they don't give out. But once it's time for Ramadan like this, you see them, take this. During this time, they remember, like they get to give out to their mates. Yes, that is it again. I think I love that. And during this month of Ramadan, you see many things, like many new things. Like when you take in terms of meat, there is some meal that is so special to them that they don't easily do. Maybe it's during parties also, but during this time of Ramadan, you see they may even be cooking that meal every blessed day. Oh, I know it's not really easy, especially when we talk in terms of cleaning the dishes. So you may stand for more than an hour cleaning, of which you won't easily finish it. And at the end of the day, you'll be so stressed. And that is the same thing you will do tomorrow. And apart from this, there are houses, again, that maybe if there is only one maid here, of which it will be very hectic, we be the one to cook. And then at the same time, do the house cleaning, of which I know it's not really easy, so hectic. That is the reason why many maids do. Yeah, maybe once you tell them Ramadan is approaching or it's time for Ramadan, they will be so sad about it. Like they won't be happy because of the stress. Like it's so stressed during this month of Ramadan. It's not really easy for housemaid. Many housemaid in Arab country. Like even if you are the type that doesn't have much work, but promise you during this month of Ramadan, you'll be involved in so many work. Like you won't have that time for your, you don't have more time to rest. And even if you should have time to rest, before you know, like you won't find it easy. Like maybe you wanted to sleep, everything is based on time. Before you know, you have to set your alarm. Okay, this time I have to do this, I have to do this. That is why many housemates don't find it funny. But to many Muslim, I think it's an opportunity for us maybe to get more closer to God. Like yes, during this time you have more time to pray, especially at night, because in a normal day many of us find it difficult to wake up and pray. It's just few who have that strength or zeal to do so always. But working here, I don't think it's not really easy for you to maybe once you are done for the day, wake up at night and pray. Yes, guys, I think this is one of the main reasons for me. I love Ramadan. I know about the stress, it's not that easy in other side, but in other side also, I also love it because it takes me more closer to God. And again, during this Ramadan, you get to know, maybe you get to know what it feels like not to have, especially the less privileged, what they are passing through to feed in a day. Like during this Ramadan, there are many things, many lessons one gets to learn during this month of Ramadan. Yes, guys, that is just it. That is all I have to say about Ramadan, or my thought about Ramadan here in Saudi Arabia. Thank you for watching. And if you've not subscribed to my channel, please do that now as we are still talking. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. See you in my next video. Bye.